jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun.
Good morning, Avon. I'm Daryl Hardy.
And I'm Laura Ryle. Thank you for watching this holiday edition of the Oriole Report.
We begin with our look at our Avon forecast.
Thanks, Daryl. Today will be mostly rainy throughout the day. The high temperature is 46 degrees with a low of 37. Tomorrow should dry up for the weekend. It'll be rainy. It'll be 42 degrees with a low of 31. Sunday will be partly cloudy with a high of 43 and a low of 30. The cloudy weather will continue next week. And looking ahead to Christmas Day, right now it's looking like it will be cloudy with a chilly high temperature of just 29 degrees. Back to you.
Thanks, Ethan. With winter break just a week away, you may be looking for fun things to do. Here are a few ideas.
If you are bored, here are some fun things to do in the winter. Enjoy the holidays with the Jolly Day Winter Wonderland. Have fun sliding down the two-story Yule slide and visiting Santa. You can drive downtown and see the Circle of Lights, or you can go ice skating at either Avon Town Hall Park or the Indiana State Fairgrounds. We talked to an Avon High School student, Spencer Botner, about how fun skating was.
I mean, for me, as like a premier skater, it's pretty fun. You know, like the glass, like, I mean, the ice, it's not like real ice. Like, you get that real ice feel from it, you know? And just being known as like the skater of our generation, it really helps me out with my practice for the 2022 Winter Olympics. This place is a very good, great staff. Connor and Caden Matting, really champions for this this town, this community. You know, I got some complimentary skates. And they're just great guys. They know how to run a business. They know how to run a family fun business, really.
Last but not least, you can walk around the Indianapolis Zoo and see the lights and animals. Have fun this winter. For AHS News, I'm Grace Harrison.
Many of us give and receive gifts around the holidays, but that can get pretty expensive really fast. So here are some cheaper gift options that might help you out.
The holidays can be very expensive, making it hard for us to give gifts. A fun and less expensive solution to this problem is to make DIY presents. Here are a few ideas. Candy-filled Christmas ornaments. This simple gift idea is creative and tasty. Just take clear plastic or glass Christmas ornaments and fill them with candies like Skittles, M&Ms, or any other small candy. Then top with a bow or handmade gift tag. Reindeer hot chocolate. For all the hot chocolate lovers, this gift is perfect. Just fill clear cake icing bags with hot chocolate mix and a few marshmallows on top. Tie it all together with brown pipe cleaner antlers and give it a nose and a pair of googly eyes. Painted glass bottles or jars. All you need for this creative gift is a glass bottle, jar, or some other clean surface, a paintbrush, and various acrylic paints. You can paint anything you want for winter scenes, Santas, or anything else. Let them dry and give us a gift. Now get out there and get creative to create the perfect holiday gifts. For AHS News, I'm Emily Roach.
And now, it's time to test your holiday knowledge with another round of trivia. Here we go.
Oh, hey, didn't see you there. Yeah, that's right, it's me, America's sweetheart, Grant Roof. Thank you for joining me for another episode of trivia. Today we're gonna be tackling the mother of all months, December. So let's see how much people actually know about Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, New Year's, and many more. What is Santa's original hair color?
Hair color?
Yeah.
Blonde.
Nope.
Brunette?
No.
What colors are there, dude?
I mean, there's one. I mean, I can think of like three more.
Redhead? He's not a redhead.
Yep. Oh. He's a ginger. All right.
Is this thing on?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready.
All right. What's your name?
Elijah.
What grade are you in?
I'm a 8th grader.
Alright. I'm going to ask you some trivia questions, is that right?
I hope so.
Okay. Ooh. What does Santa give to bad children?
He gives them what they deserve.
How many candles are on the menorah?
8. It's 8 or 9, one of those two.
You have to choose one.
I want to say 8, but it's 9.
It's 9. What animal did Ross Geller dress up as for Christmas on the popular sitcom Friends?
No?
That's interesting. An elf.
I said animal.
A Wookiee.
Yes, of course, nope. A Wookiee.
A Wookiee, yeah.
A penguin.
No. It's more exotic.
A cheetah.
No.
Black Panther.
I love that movie, but no.
A cheetah. A cheetah or something like that.
I don't watch it.
It's a holiday armadillo! Is mistletoe edible?
No. No. Mistletoe? Isn't that something you kiss under? No, it shouldn't be. It's too high. I can't reach it. No, it's not edible. No.
Give three nicknames for Santa Claus and Santa doesn't
care. I got Nick.
Father Christmas and, shoot. Say Nick, Father of Christmas, and, no!
Mr. Claus? I don't know. Is that one?
No, Santa Claus.
Scott Calvin!
Thank you for joining me on this episode, Trivia. We hope you had fun. For AHS News, I'm Grant Roof.
December is also a time to reflect on the year. Our Elijah Yabara takes us through the top video games of the year.
We've all played video games this year, whether if it was BitLife or if it was Fortnite. Video games come and go, but the best ones deserve to be recognized. These are the top 10 video games of 2018, brought to you by the Oriole Report Video Game Roundup. Number 10 is Madden 19 with Metacritic score of 80. This game has a more immersive and more realistic football gameplay, rated E for everyone, and is available on Xbox One and PS4. Number 9 is Far Cry 5 with Metacritic score of 81. You play as a rookie cop trying to bring down a cult and bring Montana back to former glory, rated M for mature and available for PS4 and Xbox One and PC. And number 8 is Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze with Metacritic score of 86. Play as a classic Donkey Kong to help him and his friends get back to home from Vikings. Rated E for everyone and is available for Nintendo Switch and Wii U. Number 7 on our list is Assassin's Creed Odyssey with a Metacritic score of 87. You become a legendary Spartan hero and write how history unfolds. It plays on Xbox One, PS4, and PC. Rated M for mature. And number 6 is Spider-Man with a Metacritic score of 87. Plays the same web-slinging hero and fight bad guys all throughout New York. Plays on PS4, rated T13. Number 5 is Call of Duty Black Ops 4 with a Metacritic score of 88. Black Ops returns in your face, featuring gritty, grounded, and fluid multiplayer combat, massive zombies, and blackout mode, rated M for mature, and is on PS4 and Xbox One. Number 4 is Forza Horizon 4 with a Metacritic score of 92 and is considered a must-play. This game has a new dynamic season change and over 450 cars, rated E for everyone, and is out on Xbox One. As we wind down to number 3 is Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, with a Metacritic score of 93 and is considered a must-play. Play as various characters from various classic Nintendo games, but now faster and better, rated E, 10 and up, and is available for the Nintendo Switch. Number 2 is God of War, has a Metacritic score of 94 and is considered a must-play. Play as Kratos, a Spartan warrior who was tricked by a Greek god Ares. You work to become the new God of War, rated M for mature and available for PS4. Before we get to number 1, I should probably mention some of my personal favorites, such as The Crew 2 and the Spiral Reignited Trilogy. And as we go down to the number 1 video game of 2018, the number 1 video game is Red Dead Redemption 2 with the Metacritic score of 97 and is considered a must-play. This game shows the ending of the Wild West and takes place in the year 1899. Plays on PS4 and Xbox One. Rated M for mature. You might have enjoyed games of 2018, but 2019 is right around the corner, so keep your eyes peeled to see what will make next year's list. For AHS News, I'm Elijah Ibarra.
2019 is just around the corner. As we get ready to celebrate the new year, and that means New Year's resolutions, we caught up with some students to see what their goals will be.
With students and faculty about their New Year's resolutions, here's what they had to say.
To study more so I can get better grades. This year, for next year, I would like to travel more. My wife and I travel all the time, so we want to get out on the road some more and see some more of the United States. And that's really about it. It's my only goal.
Okay, so I don't really make New Year's resolutions because I can't keep them that well. So I just make like positive lifestyle changes. So for the next year, I'm hoping that I can like have a healthier lifestyle, working out, eating better, day by day.
Normally they're to do better at school, go to sleep earlier, eat healthier.
I want to kind of try to eat healthy and maybe work out more.
I'm trying to get buff for prom, you know, that's in March. Trying to play better golf, be a better basketball player, you know what I'm saying?
Start focusing more in class, you know, just turn in the homework actually.
Buy a car.
Man, those are some good resolutions. For HS News, I'm Kevin Hoke.
And don't forget, tonight is the dance recital starting at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. Avon TV will be there selling DVDs for $20 cash or check only before and after the show.
And now it's time to wrap up our last show of the semester.
And on behalf of the Oriole Report, we want to wish you all good luck on finals and a safe and relaxing holiday break.
And before we wrap up this holiday special Oriole Report, we have a quick message from Santa himself.
Ho, ho, ho! I want to take a few minutes to wish you all a Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year, and don't forget to bring bottle caps to Victor. See ya! Ho, 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 ho!